click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, we have seen what do you mean by the convection and its role of the fluid dynamics. Hello friends, we have seen convection and what is the role of the fluid dynamics in its convection. Now we need to understand one more concept for the analysis. The concept name is velocity boundary layer. Now let us look at the velocity boundary layer. Consider a plate which is kept in a stream flow. Now the velocity of the stream flow is, let's say, u infinity. Now what will happen as the stream flow approaches this plate? Initially the velocity of the stream flow was, let's say, u infinity. Now since it is obstructed by some plate, the velocity which is very near to the first layer of the plate will be zero. Now this they call as a leading edge. And then what will happen as we gradually go in the upward direction, the velocity will keep on increasing. So the first layer will experience zero velocity, and as we go upward, the molecules which are, or the particle which are next to the layer adjacent to the solid layer, will obviously the velocity of that particle will retard. So correspondingly the velocity of the adjacent particle in the upward direction will start retarding. So as we can see here, we can draw a simple diagram and we can indicate that the velocity near the leading edge is zero, and then as we go to the upper layer, the velocity will keep on increasing. As we go in the upward direction, the velocity will keep on increasing. Now this is due to the no slip condition that exists in the fluid dynamics. Now this will cause the velocity gradient inside the fluid. Now this velocity gradient is responsible due to the presence of the viscosity of the given fluid. The given fluid is having some viscosity, and because of this dynamic viscosity, or the presence of the dynamic viscosity, there will be the velocity gradient that will exist in a given fluid. One must understand that till certain distance, now again this will depend on the u infinity, but as we have seen previously that the flow can be a laminar, transition and turbulent flow. So similarly, the boundary layer can be drawn separately for these three cases. That is, for the laminar, then the transition flow, and then the turbulent flow. The laminar flow is when the Reynolds number for the flow over a flat plate, if the Reynolds number is less than 3×10⁵, then we can say that we are having a laminar flow. And for the laminar flow, the boundary layer will look something like this. Then there comes the transition flow, which is in between 3×10⁵ to 5×10⁵. If the Reynolds number is in between this, then we are having the transition region, and then beyond that we are having a turbulent region. So it is shown in the turbulent region as well, the velocity boundary layer, which is similar to this one here. Now the difference will be, in case of a laminar boundary layer, this curve, which is a parabolic in nature, okay, this curve will be somewhat sharp. This curve will be somewhat sharp over here in case of a laminar region, and in case of a turbulent region, this will be somewhat like this. So basically the change is sudden for the fluid region, and then the velocity gradient will remain constant, literally constant after that. So in case of a turbulent flow, the velocity gradient will keep on changing slowly after certain layer. Now this is the difference between the boundary layer thickness. Now this is the difference between the velocity profile in case of a laminar flow and in case of a turbulent flow. Now there is something called the boundary layer thickness. They are calling this as del. Now what do you mean by the boundary layer thickness? It is nothing but the distance from the plate till which the velocity of the fluid particle is almost or 0.99 that of the velocity of the free stream. So means what? Obviously, as we have seen that the velocity at the bottom is zero and it is keep on increasing as we go in upward direction. So there will be some place where the velocity of the fluid will be almost equal to the velocity of the free stream. Now this region, now what, why this concept itself is there in the existence? Now for that we need to understand few of the fluid dynamic equations. Now two of the very important fluid dynamic equations are the Navier-Stokes equation, they call it as the NS equation, and then the Euler's equation. Newton's second law, that is summation of force is equal to mass into acceleration. So we also call this mass into acceleration is also called as the inertial force. And then in the summation of forces, there are two forces that we need to consider, the body force and the surface forces. The body force is mostly the weight, and then surface forces, again there are so many forces that can be considered. In case of a Navier-Stokes equation, we only consider the pressure force and the viscous force. See, the same Navier-Stokes equation is written over here mathematically. See, this u dou u by dou x plus v dou v by dou y plus w dou v by dou w by dou z. Now where u, v and w, they are nothing but velocity in x, y and z directions. So these are the velocity in x, y and z direction. This indicates basically the mass into acceleration term, that is the inertial force. And to the right hand side we have the pressure force, that is dp by dx. Now since the pressure is decreasing in the x direction, we need to introduce this minus sign over here. Rho into g, now this is nothing but the weight force, and then the viscous force. Now this is your Navier-Stokes equation. And then one more equation we need to understand, that is the Euler's equation. So the difference between Euler equation and Navier-Stokes equation is that in the Euler equation we do not consider the viscous force. For the surface forces, the only force that will come into picture is the pressure force. There won't be a viscous force in case of the Euler's equation. So your differential equation, this is the second order differential equation, that will not come into picture for the Euler's equation. Now with this understanding, again let us look in this picture, what are we having. See, we have made two regions thanks to this boundary layer concept. In the first region we have the viscosity gradient. So the velocity gradient is quite predominant in this region, and as we go up, see, if we try to draw a diagram beyond this, it will be nothing but the horizontal lines. So here the velocity gradient does not exist, and here it do exist. Now since the velocity gradient does not exist at the upper layer, what we can say that the viscosity is predominant in this region and it is not so in this region. So we can apply the Navier-Stokes equation on this region only. Beyond this we can use the Euler equation. We have seen previously that in case of a Navier-Stokes equation we have a second order differential, so it is quite tough to solve the second order differential for the entire region. So with this concept we have converted this entire region into two region. For one part we can apply the NS equation, and for the other part we can apply the Euler's equation. Now this understanding is very important from the heat transfer point of view, because for the heat transfer analysis and for sake of simplification, it is better to go for the Euler's equation and minimize the NS equation area. Now this is all in this topic. In this topic we have talked about what do you mean by the velocity boundary layer and what is the boundary layer thickness, that is this del. We have also talked about why is this concept is existing. Now that depends on the NS equation and Euler equation and its significance in heat transfer. Thank you for watching this video. Please stay tuned with Ekida and subscribe to Ekida. Thank you.